fabulous pop-up shop project along the Danforth East. We've gathered together all kinds of amazing people here today that are doing innovative things in their neighborhood, that have ideas to share with you and things to show you about how to open successful businesses, get people out on the street, find bumping places, as Jim Deere has always talked about, the places where people meet one another and get to say hello and feel like they're really part of the community. So it's this morning we'll hear some big picture ideas from our keynote speaker, Jennifer Kiesmatt, and Michael Smith, who is the Director of Real Estate at Street Sense. And they developed a toolkit for vibrant streets in Washington that they're now sharing in their not-for-profit arm. And then in the afternoon, we'll invite you to choose the workshops and presentations that you'd like to learn the most about. You'll have a choice of three different sessions, and you'll really get some hands-on time to chat with the presenter and get some facts and information and ideas to go off and do these things in your own neighborhood. So as we get ready for our keynote, Jennifer Kiesmatt, I would just like to introduce you to my boss at WoodGreen, Diane Dyson. She's the Director of Research and Public Policy, and she leads a staff team in the Strategic Initiatives Unit. And her professional interests are neighborhoods, demographics, community service, social networks, education systems, poverty, all topics that she actively tweets and blogs about. And although Diane tries to stay out of the limelight, everybody knows her. She has an ability to zero in on key issues, share knowledge, unite people into action, and affect positive change. So welcome, Diane.
Opportunity. The reason she's teasing me is my Twitter picture at the back of my head, if you're wondering. Recognize me? All right. So I actually have the delightful task today of introducing our chief planner in the city, Jennifer Kiesmatt. Jennifer Kiesmatt is committed to creating places where people flourish. Over the past decade, Jennifer has been repeatedly recognized by the Canadian Institute of Planners and the OPPI for her innovative work in Canadian municipalities. Most recently, Jennifer was named as one of the most influential people in Toronto by Toronto Life magazine and one of the most powerful people in Canada by Maclean's magazine. Her planning practice is characterized by an emphasis on collaboration across sectors and broad engagement with municipal staff, council, developers, business leaders, non-governmental organizations, and residents' associations. Jennifer is not only all these great things though, she's also a chief planner who bikes to work. She's one who's preeminent on Twitter and engages in conversations regularly with people who have questions about our city. I first fell in love with her when she began to host PBS-style town halls where you could join in online or in present, as she moderated all the divergent and diverse and celebratory views that we have about these cities. She's, and I am grateful for this, spoken out on the importance of community hubs, and so we are delighted today to invite her to speak today about commercial renewal of Main Streets, as we expect to be able to move things there as well. Thank you, Jennifer. Please join us now.